Welcome to Plus Canada's gala concert evening, a wonderful Yiddish-Jewish music and song featuring one of the historic stars of stage and screen, Theo Bikel. And at the piano, Tamara Brooks, who is an international star in her own right. And assisted by a host of some of Plus Canada's key faculty, former scholarship recipients, and even a present-day scholarship awardee. In a sense, what you see tonight is the full spectrum of artists from the pioneer figures like Michael Alpert, Jeff Warshauer, who are our artistic directors, Deborah Strauss, and a younger generation of faculty that is former scholarship awardees, Eric Stein, Josh Dolgan, and Alex Kantarovich, and a present-day scholarship recipient, Eva Bootman, who's working her way up through the ranks and who represents some of the future of this fascinating world of Jewish Yiddish culture and the arts. What you will be enjoying tonight is an example of the kaleidoscopic experience of Plus Canada and its goals. The Youth Scholarship Program, which awards over 100 scholarships each year, is unique in the world. And it is for that reason that we are glad that you are here and that you're joining us and supporting this particular initiative. I want to thank Herschel Siegel for his continued support and serving as chairman of this particular concert, and thanks to the many supporters who labored to make this evening an artistic and a financial success. So now on with the show, an intimate evening with Theo Bikel and friends.
Thank you. that's in you. Well, we'll take a poll. How many people speak Yiddish, understand Yiddish? Now, second poll, how many don't? You are outnumbered. Huljet, huljet, Kinderlach, von Smanien sind noch jung, weil von Frieden bis zum Winter ist der Katzensprung. Frolic, play, my little ones, while you're young and gay. Now it's spring, but winter time is but a jump away. Huljet, 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 Kinderlach, von Smanien sind noch jung, weil von Frieden bis zum Winter ist der Katzensprung. Spielt der liebe Kinderlach vor solchen Augenblick, vor solchen Augenblick. Nehmt mich euch herein ins Spiel, vergibt mir euer das Glück. Nehmt mich euch herein ins Spiel, vergibt mir euer das Glück. Oh, 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 den Kinderlach, als Mann, wir sind noch jung. Weil du Frieden bist zum Winter, dieser ganze Spruch. Und die Stunde braucht, hat sich stets an die Spiel, sich stets an die Spiel. Meine Schule ist noch jung, jetzt sind wir kaum viel. Meine Schule ist noch jung, jetzt sind wir kaum viel.
Was Terrible reports about you. He's terrible. You disturb the other children at their studies. And the kid says he's a terrible rapper. He doesn't even say that. You know, I had a few words with my friend Abel because he tore my mouth. So the rapper took me and gave me smacks on my behind. And I can prove it. And he says, but the father says you can chase around after pigeons. Is this a Jewish occupation to chase after pigeons? He says, no, it's a wonderful thing to look at the pigeons. It's a wonderful thing. No big deal. He says, yeah, but you also broke a neighbor's window. He says, well, it's a little hole. It's easily remedied. He says, look, when you're gonna be 13 bar mitzvah, you have to study for that. He says, look, he says to his father. Grandpa used to tell me, you are no better than me. You also used to chase after pigeons. When I'm as big as you, I will learn and I will be a big man, like you.
Weil du der Sonnstein noch so gesehen, bist da genau in früher geworden, backen und erzählen der Rebbe ein, doch die, als die der Geist in seine Jungen, ich gesehen, was die den Blenden dient, Tis genau dem Rennen der Zernen. Du läufst drin und schreist in Dienst, in Sterf die Kinderlag, da was lernen.
Es ist nämlich nach dem, was der Rebbe sagt, sag schlechter Mensch, nicht nur sein Gleichen. Warum der Zehnter nicht wer geschlagt? Ich hab noch ein Tablo und Zeichen. Ich hab sich mit der Brenne zu wecken, bloß, weil er auch mit meinem Chemischen zerrissen. Mit der Apotheke von seinem Scheuß, noch mit der Nigentel euch geschmissen.
Euer soll sein Wort oder geschmier, die schreit im Rennen, ich muss euch leuten. Die läuft am ganzen Fäker in den Häuf, in Chaversief mit Janik Zeugen. Sie nur schön freien zu warten, noch teilbar sich an ihm zu jubeln. In jeder Sucht mit der Halb mit der Stein, Dem Schottens Fenster euch geschlagen.
Es ist nicht der Misstag, es ist noch bloß an euch, als die Gelesäu, wir können es verkleben. Läuft es an ihm entstehen, gibt nur euch, wie schön die Fein, die Teibalach spenden. Kind kann das nicht sehen, aber wollt sie sehen, wie schön die Fein, die Teibalach spenden. Das ist doch alles euch. Als ich kind auf dem Getäum sehe ja gegen, euch was mit der Sorge sein Motto ein Verwirr,
in grazie di io che n'hai le ore, asine che vengono in taglio io, che kempi a vasse di che more, a gli taftette teure non si sei zu weg, dos ganze leib is doch a lotte, die je junge gich a weg, und es hat kein Winden und kein Karobote.
Der Seele fremd, wir räumen das Seele von dir, a die fängt sich euch noch teilweise auf Jugend. Du bist viel besser nicht gewinnt für mir, er pflegt dich euch mit den Kranchen Schnuppen. Heim ist die Größe nach dem Wilder Zieh, ob Tat und Jung vor mir kein Beule. Als jemand sein, er so groß wie dir, will er verdienen Geld und lernen teuer.
Wonderful, extraordinary writer, lyricist, wrote hundreds of songs that were luckily preserved for us. This one is a love song. This young man goes up and down in front of his beloved's window. Her name is Rachel, or Rose, if you will. And he whistles up and he asks her to come down, and she says, "Listen, I'm busy. Walk up and down a little while, I'll be honest with you." She comes down and he kisses her on the forehead. And she says, "Listen, don't whistle. My mother doesn't like it. She says it's not Jewish." She says, "I won't do anything your mother doesn't like. I won't do anything you don't like. Anything. I'm a little synagogue every Sabbath." She says, "For that, I'll sew you a little velvet bag to put your wherewithal inside." Very difficult to translate Finnish. I know there's an English word Finnish called phylacteries. But if you say phylacteries, they think it's either a part of the body or a disease. I mean, either you know what Finn is or you don't. If you don't, phylacteries won't help you. So she's going to sew in the bag to put the phylacteries in, and he says, thank you for present, I even love your mother, and then her mother calls her back up, she has to go back upstairs, and he listens to her footsteps, and he thinks how she's going to come to him in his dream.
Stehe sie dort in Gesalle, still vertracht der Heisalle, drinnen in den Beutelschiebel, woit mein schöner Reisalle. Jeden Morgen fahrt dem Heisel, drehen sich herum, gib a Pfeif und ruf uns, Rezo! Bum, bum, bum. Erfen sich a Fenster und macht euch das alte Heisele, bald hätt mir in Stil und Gessel, als ich's unsere Presele. Wart a Weile vor mein Lieber, bald wenn ich sein frei, dreh sich noch ein paar Mal wieder ins Zimmer rein. Geh ich mir auf Freilich, geh und knack mir in die Salach, er kann die Krepp noch läufen, ihre trockene Viehzalach. Schöner auf das letzte Krepp und nimm mit ihr an, gib ihr still ein Kuschelkirchen und Werder wird nicht lieben hier, du sollst da läuft nicht pfeifen mehr. Herrst der Pfeift schon, sagt die Mame, sie ist für uns verdrießlich sehr. Pfeifen, sagt sie, ist nicht jüdisch, passt doch wohl uns kann sein. Gib ein Zeichen, Prost auf jüdisch, eins, zwei, drei. Ich will auch nicht pfeifen mehr, der Leute gibt mich ein Schuh alle. Frum sei du willst noch Rezel, frum wie du mein Snubberle. Frum sei wie du willst noch Rezel, wie dein Mame frum. Jeden Schad ist gegen den Gleisel, kum, kum, kum. Erfahre ich mein Liebchen, dir mein Teil der Wippel, euch nähe an vielen Säckel, mit am Morgen der Wippel. Und euch du wirst ein gegen den Gleisel, so um sonst zu sehen, dass auch euch genäht mein Rezel ins Zentrum. Thank you. fratel Bartolome, ich lieb das Eulich Reisalem, ich lieb das Gessel, ich lieb die Mame, ich lieb das alte Heisalem, ich lieb auf die Doppel, die Steine, kretzt euch sehr um, herrscht dein Mame, rief schon, Reisalem. Geh und knack mir in die Sack, er kommt die Treppe häufen, ihre trockene Fies. Wieder still das alte Heißel, das Gessel wieder stumm, komm zu mir, komm den Reisel, komm.
Safe cocoon, we do not fear each other's touch. This tender war
is never ending. I love you still, my sweet, my tender love, I love you still. I've loved you always and I always will. Now more than ever, I adore you. Oh, mon amour, mon doux, mon tendre, mon merveilleux amour. De l'aube éclair jusqu'à la fin du jour. Je t'aime encore, tu sais, je t'aime.
Since I always like to be topical and timely, I'm going to sing you a song about Purim. What do you want? I wasn't here then, I'm here now. So wherever I am, whenever I'm there, that's when Purim is. For the sake of the two Gentiles in the audience, I will hasten to explain the significance of Purim. The Jewish festival of Purim, the Jewish festival of Purim. I know some people talk that way. They learn that in Cincinnati. Some of my best friends. Anyway, so they say things like the Jewish festival of Purim is not so much noted for its religious significance as for its historicity. Well, in that regard, it's second only to Chanukah. But briefly, the story of Purim is the story of a Persian king by the name of Ahasuerus, or Ahasuerus, whichever book you read, who at one point commanded his queen Vashti to come before him and his companions without any clothes on. I'm not making this up. This is documented in scripture. I'm not a gossip. Not given to tattle or tittle. No, he commanded his queen to come before him like that, naked. The queen was outraged. And she sent back a reply wherein she stated, and here I'm quoting directly from scripture, she said, I don't want to. I have a headache. King says she has a headache, fine, let's have her beheaded. They did that in those days, they were cruel people, they cut off her head. The king, who was not a very bright person, suddenly discovered that he was bored and lonely. You're bored, you're lonely, what do? You start asking around, where do I go, where's the action? So who do you ask? You ask your advisors or your visors. Or if you're Persian king, you ask your viziers. And he had an advisor who was an evil, obnoxious, poisonous human being who hated Jews. An occurrence, alas, not uncommon in the history of mankind. But this evil, evil advisor by the name of Haman, I can't help doing that, it's a reflex act. He said to the king, listen, let's kill the Jews, it'll while away a weekend. And a king who, as I said, wasn't too bright, said, yeah, that's cool, let's do that, I give the order, make haste. So they started preparing, building gallows all over the place. The Jews, understandably, were not thrilled. Notably one, Mordechai by name, who sat in the gate. They used to do a lot of that in those days. They sat in the gate and were not thrilled. And he said to himself, he used to talk to himself, because you meet a better class person that way. He said, this is a terrible edict. I'd like to do something about that. I can go to the palace, but the Jewish president can go to the palace, the Gentile president can go to the palace, the Jewish president can go to the palace, the East can go to the palace, I can go to the palace. The reason I'm talking to you like this is to prove to you that even 10 centuries ago already, they knew that years ago, many years later, on Broadway, there would be a hit. One time, Jackie Mason saw me perform and he came backstage and said, listen, I saw your performance, I was amazed. I was amazed that anybody should have the gall and stand up on the stage and be so Jewish as you. All right, back to my story. Mordechai didn't talk like Jack, I made that up. He talked funny, however. He wanted to avert this edict, so he said, I can't go near anybody with influence, but he said, I have a beautiful niece, maybe she can go where I can't go. So he says, Estival, go in the palace as a king, go and find pleasure before his eyes. That's another thing they used to do a lot of in those days. Go and find pleasure before his eyes and swat to him, swat to him.
He was from Brooklyn. So she went in there and she talked to him, and sure enough, she found pleasure before his eyes. And before you knew it, the king married her. It may have been stupid, but it was honorable. He married her. A couple of nights later, they're alone together, so she whispers in his ear, she says, listen, King Laban, now you got me, you're no longer bored and lonely. What do you need to kill the Jews? And the king says, that's right. That's right. I don't have to do that no more. Another direct quote from scripture. And he says, cancel the order. So she says, but we have a perfectly good gallows downstairs. Why did it go to waste? Why not let's take Haman and do it to him instead? And the king says, that's cool, let's do that. I give the order, thus it shall be, and thus it was. Now, why am I telling you all this? A couple of reasons. First of all, I like to tell it because it comes out good for the Jews. Secondly, I'm leading up to a song. The song was written by a Yiddish poet by the name of Itzik Manger. We imagine a band of tailors acting out the story of Purim on the stage. And for him, it wasn't enough to tell the straight story of Purim, dry, as I've just told it to you. He had to embellish. He invented a new character who doesn't even occur in the Megillah. A tailor's apprentice by the name of Fasligose, who's in love with Esther, but he can't have her because she's busy in the palace saving her people. So he has him sitting in the courtyard singing to her, well, not to her, she can't hear him, she's inside, he's singing to the wall. And he's saying, remember how we loved each other, remember how we promised we would always love each other, remember the night it started to rain, we took shelter, you wore a taffeta dress. It's very important to a tailor what you wear. And we promised that we would elope to Vienna and get married after Shavuos. And then along came your uncle and changed your mind, and here you are in the palace, and here I am gambling away my life the way one gambles with cards. Tell you the truth, I wanted to go and drown myself. But then I thought, if I'm dead, who will be left to love you? So I didn't. I'll have you know that there are people who sing better than I do, and that people play better than I do, but there is nobody gives better explanations. In Russian is a ring, in Russian is a pin, in Russian is a pin. Der Wind soll oben seich, wo der Weg ist hin, wo der Weg ist hin. Und noch ist auch die Psyche, der Vetter in der Heim, der Vetter auch der Heuke, und dann noch gebrannte Brei. In Russian is a ring, in Russian is a pin, in Russen is a wind. Der Wind soll oben seich, wollt a weg geschwind, wollt a weg geschwind. Fast Rigosse, der Schneider jung, dreht sich unter die Fenster. Gedenkst du es wohl, du hast mir gesagt, als ich bin bei dir der Schönste. Gedenkst du es wohl, du hast mir gesagt, als ich bin bei dir der Beste. Verwurschst du mich auch genannt, so geht los, Esther. Gedenkst du jede Nacht, mir seine Gestanden in teuer, so geringt und ich hab dir gesagt, ach so die Neue, ach so die Neue. Lang mir beide an Gläufen kein Wien und lang mir auch Hufe stellen, aus dem uns getrocken nach Sitzen klebt und euch ein Schnierbräute grellen. Hast du sich verheuchelt und gesagt, nun der Vetter. Der Vetter, wenn doch sein ich has, ist meine, meine Vetter. Und mir oben gegeben sie die Hände, und ob geschmust aus die Herde. Mir zerschellen euch Schabes noch Schmues, mit sein ich has, es ist die Herde. Ist doch in der Vetter übergewählt, und du liegst im Palast dort. Und ich hab verspielt meine junge Jörg, wie Jakob Tioschnik in Korten. Und ist gelaufen, Esther und Freund, aber ob zum Teil sich trinken, ob ich moin wärst heute heim, soll ich noch dir nicht denken. Wo sind gelassen, Esther und Freund, wo bleiben euch alle weg? Ob ich moin wärst, wirst du mir kommen, ein Kind. Und wäscht mir Socken, das hält ich gern. Mein Schönster und mein Bester, verkochst du mich hocken an. So, gib loschen Äste. So, gib loschen Äste.
Early time, at a very early time in his life, he became a thief. He was put
a seasoned criminal, but he takes from the rich, he doesn't take from the poor, because he remembers that when he needed bread, the poor gave him bread, the rich chased him away, saying it's just another thief. So I became as if he said, this will not endure for very long. He says, I'm sick from the beatings, and I'm ill from the wet with prison walls. I just had one request that after I'm dead, you should write on my gravestone in large gold letters, "Here lies our friend." If only a mother had looked out for him, if only the dirty street had not educated him, if only he had a father, he might have been a great man. But here lies our friend, a regular guy.
Hat nur gehabt, doch nicht verbrechen.
Gelle, Wolle, Jagd.
With extraordinary prescience, Duverti wrote a song after a pogrom that was called As Brent Our Village Is Burning. And you stand and you do nothing. Do something while our village is burning, our town is burning, and it will be reduced to ash, to ashes, and you do nothing. Do something. Help put out the fire. It was.
Actually from the liturgy, it's Hazonish, the Bodhi Beis HaMikdash.